So our next presenter is going to be Dr. C.A.P. Prabhu, who heads the Shushruta Eye Hospitals Mysore, a very popular figure in his region, a great surgeon with innovative skills, and he's going to show us some more information. On to you, Dr. Prabhu. Can you share your screen?
Yeah, I'm sharing. Just one minute. This has got narration. I think hardly I need to say anything orally. This was a normal case. The other eye was already operated. The patient had a PCIOL with 6-9 good vision. This was a mature cataract. So this was a routine case. I didn't expect any sort of issues in the beginning. A normal axis was done. I did do the normal hydro dissection. Nothing was unusual as far as I seen on that day, at that particular moment. I was not sure, but still I was able to study the very mature cataract. Usually I don't too much bother about rotation. I mean, just I could sort of a rock a little bit and I was comfortable. Then I just started to help and there's a nucleus drop. I'm just replaying it. They're just hardly about to start the sculpting. There is a nucleus drop. So now the question was what I should do and why did this happen? Of course, I think at that point of time only I had to close the wound. So I had to sort of remove whatever nucleus was prolapsing. So I just injected like tricot, the ports. My aim was to remove as much as possible from the anterior chamber and whatever is into the wound. Tricot could make out the vitreous strands very well delineated, so I could remove all the vitreous from all the ports. And whenever we had this patient, what we feel is whatever particle matter is just behind the capsule, that should also be removed because it will be a little more easy for us to remove instead of leaving it to the vitreous surgeon. So what I am just trying to do is try to remove first thing was to close the main wound so that there is no again other vitreous loss from that wound or vitreous collapse. So I'm just trying to remove the vitreous from the chamber. One should use the vitreous cutters with like both the IA cut A and IA cut mode, so that is IA cut mode, we can try to remove all the lens matter that is just behind the anterior capsule, and I just make sure that there is no vitreous in the anterior segment before I could abandon the surgery on that particular point of day or time. So obviously I had to take help of our vitreoretinal surgeon. So after nearly 4-5 days later, we did the vitrectomy. The surgeon could remove the lens of the lens. Because the anticapsule rim was intact, we could put the three-piece lens in the sulcus. But the question is, why did the nucleus happen? Whether it could have been predicted? Could it have been prevented? That's something which is still bothering me. I really look forward to the experts to give me suggestions as what could have been done better, or is there any way to anticipate?
Could you stop sharing? Dr. Prabhu, that was a very wonderful teaching video you showed as to how you would manage if you are caught in this kind of a situation. You have told us all the very relevant steps. Must have been an occult PPC total cataract which you could not visualize. That's where the role of these anterior segment OCTs come in, like we are able to understand these things earlier on, or sometimes you could see the other eye, and if there has been a PCR, that also gives you some thought to be more cautious. You may not have, could have avoided the hydro altogether. The other relevant question here is, that placing an IUL on the sulcus, in which situation would you not place? And in our setup, like our retina surgeons, what they would advise is you could place your IUL in any situation. And if you can do a good vitrectomy and then in the mid vitreous, and then you could place a 22 gauge fragmentome and you could eat up the nuclear fragments all in one sitting at one go, it could be managed. So I want the thoughts of the expert, whoever all of you could give, chip in as to when would you place a lens, when you would not, and what extra precaution could you have taken in this kind of a case?
Basically, I would not try to put a three-piece lens if my CCC is not intact. If my CCC is not intact, most often in these situations, we try to put a retrofixated lens, just consider the end of the pupil and then put a retrofixated lens. Only because this was a patient where the CCC was intact, so without enlarging the incision, I could put a three-piece lens. So that's what I could say. But there is no way to, otherwise, this was a pseudophakic patient and the patient was operated elsewhere. So there was no PCR. So I had no clue, and because I don't have this thing, we could have done the B scan, but in every mature cataract, we do the B scan. We can only see whether there's any posterior segment pathology. That B scan that we routinely use doesn't delineate the posterior capsule very well.
Yes, Dr. Kamal.
I think beautifully managed, Dr. Prabhu. You showed all the steps which were to be seen by the audience. One or two points which Dr. Chitra, she manages to come out with these questions which actually stimulate your mind. I would put an IOL in any situation, but if the nucleus is very hard, brown, black, because that is the situation where my retina surgeons often tell me that, sir, don't put the lens and we can, live to do it another day. Another thing is why this rent could have happened is, of course, as Dr. Chitra said, you could have a unilateral PPC also. I have patients where they just have one unilateral PPC and the cataract has got mature. I remember operating such patient 5 years ago, similar situation as yours, and I just started the trenching. The moment I trenched, the nucleus went down and the other eye was operated elsewhere and everything was fine. But I actually feel sometimes this could also happen because of a little bit of over-aggressive hydro procedure. You could have a capsular block, the PC could have just slightly opened, but this is all hypothesis. You're trying to revisit the whole thing once it's happened. But yes, it is intriguing that, nothing you've done. And of course, you have to face the patient the next day morning. And the patient, I always tell my associates, junior associates, that no patient can actually give you credit that you do a cut open a rexis, which is 10 microns capsule. You make a perfect round rexis. You are able to operate in a distance of 2.8 millimeters with a machine which is cutting at 40,000 cuts per second. All they are bothered is next day they want to see. So the patient will never understand that. And it's good to revisit why it could have happened. But yes, Dr. Chitra, I think you could put the three-piece lens in the sulcus. And even in case there is not a non-intact rexis, I've got away putting these three-piece lenses. You should just know where to land the leading piece and then how you're going to put in. So suppose as you want to dial in, the dialing last part should not rest on the torn rexis. So then you can use a forceps to just fold the trailing loop and leave it under the rexis. And in case you have enough room to dial the lens in, and then you could ensure that none of the loops goes over the torn area. So because these three-piece lenses are pretty huge in diameter, and once they go in, they'll fit very snugly. So I guess maybe not for beginners, but a take-home message is, in case you have a peripheral extension or capsule rexis, you can get away by putting a three-piece lens very, very safely.
Can I just add on?
Yes.
No, basically, I have tried to put the three-piece lenses in many cases of PCs, and always it is best to put the lens on the iris and then wherever you want to, you align it to the lens.
Absolutely.
And then use the MVR forceps to just sort of a bend the haptics and just push it below the iris. We should never try to put it into the sulcus in one go. That is my philosophy.
True.
I think that's
Absolutely.
A very important point for at least the juniors who may be interested to, watching the video.
I completely agree with you, Prabhu, with the sense that, it would be a good idea to inject the lens into the anterior chamber and fill in some viscoelastic in the sulcus and then gently dial the lens inside the haptics inside so that they go into the rexis and not into the behind the anterior capsular rim. And as regards this particular case itself, it's possible that the earlier first eye was operated at an earlier stage when the a good surgeon notice that there's PPC and handle it appropriately. In this case, in this eye, you did not have that information. Of course, you did everything right, but it happened. It happens to all of us. And as regards whether you put a lens in the first go or not, it entirely depends on the kind of vitreoretinal support you have. We usually have a VR surgeon operating in an adjacent theater. Actually, we go ahead, do an anterior vitrectomy if faced with this situation and remove the cortex and place a lens and create an optic capture and shift the patient to the next theater for getting the nucleus handled because they have a fragmentome and they are just able to, the patient is usually a sutureless surgery. The patient doesn't even realize, of course, he has been operated in two theaters, but otherwise the outcome is nearly the same. But obviously, if the surgeon, which in the earlier days when we did not have a fragmentome or something, sometimes a hard nucleus, as Kamal said, had to be brought in through the anterior route, then obviously it may not be a good idea to put in a lens, but it can always be done at the second stage when the nucleus is dealt with. Because clipping in an intraocular lens in the sulcus is not very difficult, even for a VR surgeon, or you could do it in conjunction with them. But otherwise, I think the most important point was that, you know, you do not have to handle everything the same day. You handle it according to the situation. 5 days later, you have done the second surgery and not compromise the results. That's a very important take-home message.
Dr. Shishir, you wanted to add something? Yes, Dr. Shishir, you have anything to add? You are muted.
I am a posterior segment surgeon as well. Yeah. So usually, as a very good presentation, Dr. Abu. So I would say anterior segment surgeon, whenever there's this type of problem, if the cataract is not very hard, grade 5, grade 6, as Dr. Kamal said, and the rexus is intact, can put in an IUL so that it's easier for the posterior segment surgeon later on. He goes through the posterior segment, the pars plana route, and does the whole job. And the anterior segment is not to be touched. Do a good anterior vitrectomy with the help of tricot and put in an IUL. First put on the iris and then dial onto the anterior rexus. Yeah.
Thank you.